I wasn't coming till 6:30, Paul.
Hey, it's playoff, Kenny. How many times have you been playing? You know he starts to bet.
Calvin Kastein at the Scioto Recreation Park. Beautiful downtown Scioto. It's the 17th day of August, 2010. Yeah, we're here for first round action in the Clinton County Fireman's Softball League. It's the Altona Club on the field, and their opponents, the Ellenberg Squad. Again, Puria on a pitching rubber. Sean LeBaire is at the plate. Fred Porter is the catcher. Paul Harriman, for the moment, calling the balls and strikes. LeBaire walks, and Lee LaValle Jr. will step in. Altona number one in the league, and apparently Ellenberg was number four. Only four teams made the playoffs this year. In the other round, it's El Sable and Customs and Border Patrol. LeBaire stayed put. Can't leave till the ball is struck. Contact is made with the ball, so swing and miss. If you leave, you're out. Line shot just beyond the grasp of Jason Mayette. Fleming will run it in. And now Lee LaValle Sr. will step in for Ellenberg. Two on, nobody out. Strike.
Would I swing it?
I do too, but tons get me troublesome.
3-1 pitch. Ball four. So LaValle walks. That's going to load the bases full of Ellenbergers. Now we got Joe Hayes, who's the first baseman. He looks at a strike. And he drops a base hit into left field. Two runs will score. It's first and second. And now Rick Giro will bat. Pulled a hamstring last time we saw him in a softball game. He's still recovering. It's a fair ball. Fleming will kick it in. Here comes LaValle. He's got the afterburners on. He will score. Now we got Jason Hayes with, again, first and second. This is hit deep. Fleming grabs. And Joe Hayes will not advance. You're right, Terry. Whatever he said, he's right. Terry Puryea will bat. One out, first and second. Three runs in. Looking to practice their steal here, Fred. Throw to Ken, but that was a little high. Just a throw down, make sure nobody steals on him. Terry Puryea helps Ken out by stepping up and hitting that one. Oh, we're going to have a play at the plate. Hayes is going to score. Sean LeBaire, who's he running for? He's running for Rick Giro. Now the fellow made out the batting order. Nate LaValle will step in. Terry Puryea will get a base runner. It'll be Hayes. Jason Hayes. Still just one out. Runners at the corners. High fly ball to left field. Fleming is over in the trees. Out of play. LeBaire will score. Two down. And it'll bring up Eric LaValle, a name you heard a lot of in the last couple of weeks as we're taping this. Last time we taped to Ellenberg, it was at Beekmantown on a Tuesday. Is that actually West Shazy? And next morning, Ellenberg Fire Department was called out to the big flood in Ellenberg Depot. And Eric LaValle is the guy that you saw diving in there, risking his life to save that lady from Canada. So if you want to know what a hero looks like, there's one right there. Not that guy playing center field for your favorite team. And if you're from Ellenberg, this should be your favorite team. If you're from Altona, Altona should be your favorite team. Then cheer for the Yankees and Red Sox and whoever. Paul Harriman hits it in long throw. What a throw. What a play by Jared Puryear to get Paul Harriman. And we're going to go to the bottom of the first. They scored a bunch. Jared Puryear will lead off the bottom of the first. Team down 5-0. Terry Puryear on the pitching rubber. Rick Giroux behind the plate. Fred Porter calling the balls and strikes at the moment. That's foul.
Straighten out a little bit.
That's a base hit.
Push.
Boot it around. Puryear will stop at second with a big deficit. Now Ken Puryear telling the outfield, come in, come in. Foul, strike one. Strike two. Line shot to Nate LaValle. One down. Now gets us to Donnie Laporte. Oh!
Come on, Joe. Let's go.
They keep finding Nate LaValle. Jason Myatt. Line shot to Hayes at third. And Jason Hayes hauls it in. So four up, three down, nothing across. After one full, it's 5-0. Ellenberg leads. They weren't ready. Pitch came. Jason Myatt was over visiting with Jared Puryear. Ken Puryear delivers. And double shortstop worked. Wendy Baker is out. Top of the second. I'm trying to figure out where this catcher came from and who he replaced in the lineup. Sean LeBaire going to go for two. He's going to settle for two. He's going to be out. No, yes, he's out. He's out. Got a little greedy and they get picked off. Nice throw. Teammates say good hit, bad running. Here's Lee LaValle Jr.
Short.
It's a fair ball. Good backup by Donnie Laporte, the second baseman. Lee LaValle Sr. makes a strike.
Sorry about that, guys.
hopper ahead, 0-2. Little Valley hits a line shot, one hopper to Fleming. He'll be first and second. Well, Joe Hayes, the batter. Lee Garand is the fellow who's out of the game. I don't know why. He started. Well, short hopper to Laporte. And he can't get control of it to try his second. So, bags are full. Giro at the plate. Fly ball, it's going to go foul. Strike one. One ball and a strike. Just missed on that one. Hit to Mayette. He'll go to Laporte. Nothing across. They leave him loaded. And we go to the bottom of the second. Still 5-0 Ellenberg. Scott Fleming at the plate as we start the bottom half of the second in this 5-0 ball game. One ball, one strike. Game one, the best of three series, semifinals in the Clinton County Firemen's League. Base hit. We'll start at the bottom of the second. Now Fred Porter. Hit to left field, LeBaire grabs it, and it'll be an advance to second. One down. Then we have TJ LaValle. Hit through the left side. Fleming will score. It's a 5-1 ball game. There's Bryant LaValle. It's a, under the glove of Puria through the middle. That'll be LaValle's at the corners. Lee Guerin decided to keep playing. His son Cody, I think it's Cody, the guy who came in for him. He wasn't feeling well, and he's still not feeling up to par. It's a two short, two second, excuse me. Out at second. On a close one. Run scores, it's 5-2. Now Cameron Guerin. And it's a base hit.
Go, 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 go!
Another throw a second. Yeah, ooh.
Good job, Cameron.
Cameron Guerin hustles in. Bryant LaValle coasting out there.
Go.
Derek Puryea led off the bottom of the first with a two-bagger and then was stranded. Hit to LaValle, throw the first will be just in time. Just in time. So it's 5-2 as we head for the third inning without a replay. There's Jason Hayes. He takes a strike starting off the third inning. 5-2, his team's up. Hits it to Jared Puryea. Over to Guerin with the tag. One down. Now Terry Puryea will step in. Pitch from Ken Puryea is ball one. Fly ball in the trees. Up the middle, it's a base hit. And Terry Puryea's on, he'll get a runner. Now Nate LaValle. Ball one. Slow bouncer to first. It's going to go to second. They get him. Good play. Good play by Lee Guerin. Good choice and a good play. Danny LaPorte over covering first. So that's two down. And Eric LaValle. The batter. It's a soft line. Oh, Lee Guerin. Take a base hit away from Lee LaValle. Eric LaValle. We were hoping Eric LaValle would have a 5-for-5 evening. So it's still 5-2 after 2.5. We're going to the bottom of the third here on viewer supported hometown cable. Ken Perrier hits it 2-3. He's going to be on. If he. No. Oh, he's called safe. Called safe. Jared Perrier, you have to run. If you can't see Ken, it's because he's camouflaged. Oh. If he suddenly disappears, you know why. Donnie LaPorte is at the plate. He hits a base hit. First and second. Potential tying on the plate now. It's Jason Mayette. Off the glove of Jason Hayes. Over to Joe Hayes. Everybody's safe. So the bags are full for Scott Fleming. Nobody out here in the third. That's a base hit. They'll drive home two runs. LaPorte will score easily. Mayette will coast into third. They'll be first and third. It's a 5-4 game. Fred Porter. It's a high fly ball foul, strike one.
Come on, Porter.
1-1 pitch. Two balls and a strike. Hit to third. Save it first. Run number five scores.
Come on, Red Bull.
Tie game. TJ LaValle, the batter, would man it first. Two outs. You saw LaBear hold up. That's because the out of play line is right there. He's trying to stay in play. Two balls, two strikes, two outs, ball three. Payoff pitch is hit to left. The bear grabs it. Oh, that's the second out. I thought there were two already. That's the second out. There's Bryant LaValle.
Yeah, let's get one here.
Seventh batter of the inning. Up the middle,
come
base
on, hit. Come on, Porter! Come on, Porter!
Hold on,
Two. Two out. Lee Guerin with two down. Now there are two down.
Run!
That's a fair ball. Fred Porter going to try to score. He will.
Brian, what are you doing? If you're going,
same play.
Porter, not hitting.
Oh, well, that's a go-ahead run. Cameron Guerin hits it into shallow left center. That run scored. We have to back up the tape. Here's Jared Perrier. 10th batter of the inning. Oh, the only one on. It means there's 6 runs this inning. Hit to second. LaValle will go to Hayes. And it sounds like an 8-5 game as we head for the fourth. Ball one to Paul Harriman as we start the fourth inning. It's an 8-5 lead for Altona. Fred Porter makes the catch. Now Wendy Baker.
Come on, Wendy.
Soft line shot to Perrier. 2 down. And gets us to Sean LeBaire. Slow roller. Donnie LaPorte over there to get. And Guerin fired to LaPorte for the out. So LeBaire is erased. 3 up, 3 down. We're going to the bottom of the fourth. Halfway through this one.
Let's go. Come on here, Oliver. Let's go.
Here's Ken Perrier leading off the bottom half of the fourth. Eric LaValle grabs. We have one out. Donnie LaPorte. Through. Stepped on the plate. He's out. Stepped on the plate.
Come on, Joel.
Now Jason Mayette. 2 down.
Real cute umpire. Real cute.
That line shot, it hangs up there, and LeBaire makes the catch. So we go to the fifth inning, still 8-5 Altona.
There was no way you're gonna reach that without stuff.
Come on, Johnny, let's go, boom!
Here's Lee LaValle Jr. leading off the fifth inning. His team down by 3, takes a strike. Strike 2. That's a strike the old-fashioned way. But Ken Perrier feeling confident now. Foul tipped. It's a fly ball, drops in. Cameron Guerin is there for the backup. Good attempt by Fleming, but it's that famous Sciota left field. You're running in downhill. Now Lee LaValle Sr. steps up with his junior entity at second. Yeah, he hits one to Fleming. This one holds up. Fleming has to reach for it. It's a tricky left field. One out. Joe Hayes will try to get LaValle in from third. And he hits a line shot to Jared Perrier. And no advance on that. 2 down. So Rick Giro will limp to the plate. At that pulled hamstring. We got LeBaire. LeBaire is running for him. No, LeBaire is calling the balls and strikes. LaValle, Nate LaValle is running for him. Line drive caught by Mayette. So nothing across for Ellenberg. It remains 8-5 Altona. We're heading for the bottom of the fifth. Scott Fleming at the plate. Let's see, this I believe, what I hear is Megan LaValle. Rick Giro has decided he has put enough stress on that hamstring. So he's going to do all of his grimacing in the bleachers. Ken Perrier offering friendly advice. Fred Porter hits a base hit. We got TJ LaValle. That's a base hit.
Right there.
Bryant LaValle.
Come on, Fred. Out
there.
Come on. Good call.
He is out at second. Good call. Fleming scores, so it's 9-5. Lee Guerin, the batter. And he's going to drop it in fair. He's going to roll up the hill all the way to the fence.
Go.
He's one of the most interesting runners I've witnessed over the years. Now Cameron Guerin at the plate. We got LaValle, TJ LaValle running for Lee Guerin. Nate LaValle fires to Hayes for the out. Well, Jared Perrier, the batter. Two outs, one on. Foul. 0-2 the count. Goes to Eric LaValle. Silver his glove.
Got you, Joe.
Good.
Whoa! He's out.
Didn't call me out. I should have ran.
Safe.
You're gonna have to catch her, she'll tell you.
I'm pretty sure he was out, but it's okay. I'm not bound.
It isn't because I wanted to bat.
Hey, guys, hold on.
Let's see.
All them safe. There's Ken Perrier. Under the glove of LaValle. Donnie LaCourte. Ninth batter of the inning. Hit to LaValle, knocks it down. Whoa, he goes to second. And we're going to go to the sixth inning. I think they've added five more to make it a 13-5 lead. Jason Hayes, the batter. Ellenberg scored five in the first, and they've been scoreless since. We're in the sixth. Hit to second, a bunch of hoppers. Before it goes to Garen, we have one out. Now Terry Perrier. Two down. Nate LaValle.
We should probably have a race after the game.
I'll put a 12 pack down there.
I've already run that twice.
No, don't be doing those things.
Up the middle.
Nice shot, hitter. Nice hit,
mate. I got Ken Perrier's attention. Eric LaValle. Once again, you weren't with us at the beginning. We'll mention again, he was he's the fellow who jumped in the water to save that lady in Ellenburg 2 weeks ago. LaValle hits it to center. It is caught after a late jump. TJ LaValle catches up with it. So we go to the bottom of the six. It's holding at 13-5 Altona. Ball on to Jason Mayette. We start the bottom half of the sixth. August 17th, 2010. The line shot. There. Now left fielder Scott Fleming. Hits it to straightaway center. Harriman will throw it in. And the batter now is Fred Porter. He gulps it. Strike one. Dangerous area. Strike two. Line shot to Nate LaValle. TJ LaValle. That was a strike. It's a can of corn to left. LaValle grabs. Bryant LaValle. The pop to Lee LaValle. And it's the inning. We go to the seventh inning. 13-5 Altona leading Ellenburg. Paul Harriman takes a strike to start the seventh inning. All of the Ellenburg runs coming in the first. Ken Perrier grabs it. One down. Wendy Baker. Harriman running for her. Strike one. To short, Perrier the first, two down. Now Sean LaBear becomes the last hope for Ellenburg.
Come on, Sean.
It's it to Laporte. He turns his back and still makes the play. So it's a 13-5 victory. Altona comes back to defeat Ellenburg, and that's the way it was in the Clinton County Firemen's Softball.
It is.
August 17th, 2010. Thanks for watching. For those of you supporting viewer supported local television, Hometown Cable. Win, lose, or draw, TV worthy of your support, Hometown Cable.